Today we start off our discussion about merging using SAS. Now, merging of datas are very common exercise which we have to do in every business we work with. And see, for example, there can be my customer master file, and then can be another file, can be the transaction file. We have to merge them to understand which customers purchased on which date, and from there I need to probably, from the customer master file, I need to probably bring in the customer demographics in the customer transaction file, and then based on demography do some kind of further analysis. So merging of different files is a very, very common exercise which we have to do with any business we work in. Now, to start off with the merging activity in SAS, we would first try to give some features of the SAS merging. Now, for merging to happen effectively in SAS, the files which we are merging must have a common ID. Okay. Now, this common ID, let's call it as ID. So, a common ID of the same name must be present in the files which we are trying to merge. So, both the files must have a ID variable whose name should be the same in the two files. And if they are not the same, then we have to some way rename any one of them so that they have the same name. So this is important. Second very important thing is that the two files or the files which we intend to merge must be sorted by the ID variable. So the ID variable which we are using for merging, must the datas must be sorted by that particular variable. Third, the default merge of SAS is what we call the union merge. When I say union merge, it's like the merging will happen basis the IDs, but the all possible IDs from all the files will be present in the merged file, unless and until otherwise specified. We can specify and we can restrict that, but the default merge is the union type merge. Now, to have an example of this, dummy datas are been prepared. Now, one data is the employee master file. Now, in this employee master file, I have employee IDs of employees from 1 till 100. So, there are 100 employees and their names and their qualifications. 1 stands for graduate, 2 stands for postgraduate, and 3 stands for higher, the other kind of degrees. Okay. So for each one of these employees in the employee master, we have information on these documents or on these three elements. Now, parallel, we have an employee salary file. Now, in the salary file, there are 100 employees, but these employees are IDs from employee number 51 till employee number 150. And for each one of them, I have their 12-month salary. So basically, for employee ID 51, I have month 1 to month 12 and their salaries. Similarly, for employee number 52 till employee number 150. Now, if we decide to merge these two files, the first thing which we have to do is to sort the data. So I have sorted both the data by the employee ID. So this is first and foremost thing which we have to achieve, to sort the data basis the ID variable. Now, when we decide to merge these two files, the merged file will have all the possible columns. So it will have employee ID, month, salary, as well as name and qualification. So that will be the complete set of variables in the merged file. Now, in terms of the observations for the merged file, it will have IDs spanning from employee ID 1 till employee ID 150. So all possible employee IDs will be part of the merged file. Now, how many observations will the merged file have? So if you look at this data, if I talk about employee IDs 1 till employee ID 150, out of them, employee ID 1 to 50, they are only present in the master file. So probably, and they're not present in the salary file. So probably these are the employees who are old employees of the company, and they might have left the company, but the salary file is not updated. So basically, the master file is not updated, and these people, because salary file is the file which is a sacrosanct file, because these are the payments which are being made to the current employees. But so employee ID 1 to 50, these are old employees for us, and hence their names are not featuring in the salary file. So for these people, I don't have any matching information in the salary file. So for each one of them, I actually have one row of data, because there's only their employee ID, name and qualification is there in the master file, but nothing is there in the salary file. Now, employee number 51 to 100, for them, I have all the data. Not only I have their employee ID, name and qualification, but also I have their month and salary. So for them, I have all the cells populated. Whereas employee ID 101 to 150, I don't have their names in the master file. So these are probably new joiners for us, for whom again the master is not updated, and but they are getting salary from the salary file. So now if I decide to merge these two datas, as I discussed earlier, we will be getting the name, qualification, month, salary for each one of them for all the relevant observation, but ID will span from 1 to 150, but number of observations will be, if you look at this, here employee number 1 to 50, for them, since there is no matching information in the other file, for them I will be only getting one row. So 50 observations comes for employee ID 1 to 50. Now here, apart from that, for employee number 51 to 100, I'll get how many observations? I'll get 50 into 12, that is 600 observations, because for each one of them, I have the month as well as the salary figures there. Same thing will happen for employee ID 101 to 150, but for them, these fields will be blanks because I don't have any matching information in the other file. So I will get 50 plus 600 plus 600, total 1250 rows will be there in the merged file. So how the merging happens is something like this. I merge these two files into a new data. And merging will happen by employee ID. So this by command will actually ensure that the matching happens by employee ID and then the merging happens. Okay. So if I do this now, as discussed, there's some problem with the library. I just shift the location of the library. Okay. So as discussed, this has 1250 observation and the five variables. Okay. So let's see how this looks like. Now for employee ID 1250, there is no matching information from the salary file. Hence for them, the month and salary figures are blank. So these are the employees who have already left the company. Now similarly, for employee number 51, I have their data from 1 till 12. Their salaries and their name and their qualification have appeared from the employee master file. Similarly, this will continue till employee number 100. Okay. For employee number 101 onwards, I will not have the information from the master file because their names and qualification are not there. So these are probably the new employees for us. Okay. So this is the default merge of SAS, as I discussed, is the union merge, which takes all possible IDs from the files which we are merging and all relevant observations corresponding to them. So this is the default merge. Now, we can also, or as I told you that we can also alter this list. Now, how we can alter this list is by different ways. Now, X and Y. Now, this X and Y merge is basically the intersection merge. So basically, I will be getting, if I use the X and Y merge, I will be actually getting IDs from 51 to 100, which are the common IDs. Now for that, I need to create some aliases for them. So I am calling this as X and I'm calling this as Y. This could have been some other name also. This could have been some other name also. I'm calling them X survey. Could have been A, B, C, D, X, Y, Z. But the condition for merge is if X and Y. Now, if X and Y ensures that the merging happens, but only for those IDs which are present both in X and Y. X being the salary file and Y being the master file. So here I will get 600 observations, which is only the common cases. Okay. So only the cases which are common, I will get only that list. Now there can be other variants also. Now X and not Y. Now X and not Y will give me what? It will give me the IDs which are present in salary, but not present in the master file. So basically it will give me the list of the new joinees. So probably for them, I need to add them in my master file so that for future, in future, when I do this, I get the correct master. So if I say X and not Y, so I'll get the list of again 600 people, but will be the IDs from 101 to 150. For them, I don't have the information in this particular file, right? So for these people, I need to have their name and qualifications included in my master file for my future reference. Similarly, the other one, the Y and not X. Now Y and not X here will give me then what? The IDs from 1 to 50. Basically the people who are there in the master file but not in the salary file. That means the people who have probably left the company and their name should be deleted from the master file, right? So these are the IDs which are there in the master file but not in the salary file. So their information must be deleted from the master file. So I need this list. Okay. Now, apart from that, what other alternatives do I have? We have something called if X. Now, if X is basically, which is part of X, irrespective of which is part of Y or not. So if I write if X, then if X will give me IDs from 51 to 150. So basically, I will be getting for each one of them, we have 12 rows of data. So I will be getting 1200. Rows of data in the output file. Okay, so this is 1200 observations in the output file, which is my this file which has all the employees which are there in my salary file, irrespective of they present in the master file or not. Exactly. So this is important when we are doing say matching with the transaction file and the customer master file. So all customers of my master may not be transacting in a month. So I will only take out information of people who are transacting in that particular month. So I will be only picking up the relevant information for those individuals who have transacted in the month. Okay. Then similarly, something like if Y is the other one, it will be present in master irrespective of present in salary or not. Okay. So here I'll get how many observations? 650 for IDs basically from 1 to 100, 150 observations for IDs 1 to 50, 600 more for 51 to 100. So I'll get 650 observation in this file while we do it this way. Okay. So this is the basic of merging in SAS, which is very powerful in a sense. By which we can, now here we have merged two files. Similarly, we can use this to merge multiple files also. Okay, provided they have the same ID and all are sorted by that ID variable. So we can merge them using, we can merge them simultaneously using this merge. I can use merge data 1, data 2, data 3 till data n by a common ID. So probably if I have say one file giving me the customer and the other file, suppose there are transaction in different categories. So I have prepared category wise files and then I merge them together. So for each customer, I know what is the purchase value in different categories. So across columns, I'll get different categories and I'll get their values in the merged file. So this is the basic of merging using SAS. Now the same merging concept is there in SQL also. Okay. So in SQL, the merging terminology we use is called joins. Okay. Now SQL has a similar kind of merging function. Now, while there were some features of SAS merge, they were primarily that both files have an ID variable, right? So I have to have an ID variable, same name of the ID variable. This was required in SAS. If they are not in the same name, I need to rename one of them. Similarly, I have to sort data on ID variable. This was important for this SAS merge. And the default is the union merge. So these were the features of SAS merge. While for SQL, the features are I should have an ID variable, but same name for ID variable not required. We need not have the same name for the ID variable when we merge it through SQL. I need not sort the data on the ID variable. This is not needed. Okay? I need not sort the data on the ID variable when I'm merging it through SQL. And for SQL, the default merge is the intersection merge. So for SQL, the default merge is the intersection merge, which while for SAS, it was the union merge. Now suppose I take the same data, same example, but just for the sake of having them in different names, I am just changing one of the names to something else, okay? I'm just changing the name so that we actually can exhibit that they don't require the same name. When we did it in SAS, we had to have the same names for the ID variable. This was required. Both of them had the same name, employee ID. Okay, but when we do it through SQL, they need not have the same name. Okay. So salary file, if I look at this, the name is now employee_code. The label is still remains that, but it will not affect my thing. The name is employee_code. Okay. And suppose I sort it by some other variable so that it looks a bit jumbled up. So it's not sorted on the month variable. Okay, so it's completely jumbled up. All my employee codes are completely jumbled up in this particular thing. Okay. Now, if I decide to use the SQL merge, which is the intersection merge, see how it goes. Now, any SQL code in SAS must be written after proc SQL. Okay, we write proc SQL and then only we can write all the SQL type codes in the SAS environment. Okay, so same kind of coding works here. The normal create table, say d.m1 as select. Now, if I want to select all variables from both the files, I write star from the two files which we have is d.salary and d.master. And what is the condition for merge? The condition for merge is the employee code in one file should be the same as the employee ID in the other file, right? So the employee code in this particular file must be the same as the employee ID of this particular file, right? That's the condition for merge. Now, for that, I need to again create the aliases in SQL also, right? So I call this file as X and I call this file as Y. The condition for merge is where X, which is my salary file, X dot employee code is equal to y dot emp id. So, and proc SQL always ends with quit instead of run. Okay. So, if I do this, I get how many rows I'll get? 1200. No, sorry, see, 600 rows. Only the common cases, right? The intersection merge. The only the common cases I'll get. So I've got all. So whenever employee ID is 51, I've got for him the information here. 52, I got the information here. So I get all possible information from the file. Since I'd given star, so I'm getting every information from the other file. If I'd not specified some variable, I would have only got them. But here there is some advantage is that I need not sort the data, as I told you. I need not sort the data by that ID variable. And I need not have the same name for the ID variable. These two are advantages. But otherwise, we can use sorting both using SQL as well as the normal SAS merge. Okay. Now, as this was, I wanted all my variables from both the files. Since I had given star, I could have selected some variables at this stage only. So if from the master file, I only need the name, I can specify that. So if I want everything from my X data, but from my Y data, I only require the name, I can specify that. Okay. This is sometimes which we often do because my master file can be a very large file. It can have a lot of columns, lot of variables. In the merged file, I probably will require, say I'm doing some customer communication. So probably I'll require his only email ID and phone number from my master file, because I need not have his name and so many other informations which are there in my master file. So I'll have to select only a few variables from my master file while joining itself. So if I do this, now I only get the name from this data. Okay. Okay. Now, also if I want them in a particular order, see right now it is sorted in the month variable because that's how the original data was, but I can sort it at this level also by a command called order by, right? If I order by that variable, I can say if I order by this employee underscore code, then I will get the data sorted by that particular variable. By default, ascending order. Sorry, M1. So it's now sorted on the employee ID. Okay. So for each employee ID, and if I want to sort it by employee ID and month, I can do that simultaneously, right? So employee code, month. Nah. Column. See, any activity in SAS happens by the column headings, basically, which is the variable name. Okay, any operation, be it sorting, merging, anything, any function also works on the name of the variable, which is this one. Okay. Yeah, that's what has been done. The same thing has been done here. See, not attribute, it's the name of the variable. Nothing with attribute out here. It's the name of the variable, right? Employee code is the name of the variable by which I am sort. This is the label of the, yeah. Okay, this is the name of the variable. And any code or any activity works with the name of the variable, nothing to do with the label. Okay. So basically, we can merge using both SAS and SQL, depends on the which is your more comfort level. I personally use SAS more often than SQL, but it depends on which is your comfort level. So you can use both the things to merge. Okay. So this basically concludes my discussion on merging using SAS data sets.